What's up, guys? This is the commentary part of this video. I'm just going to tell you a few things about it and explain it a little bit and show you some little hidden secrets in it, I guess. But yeah, this first location that we did was a bar in downtown LA, and it's actually in the basement of it. It's in the little speakeasy part. It's a really cool place, just a long, narrow room that worked perfect for this scene, actually. Yeah, and right now she's just getting her ear talked off by these guys, and apparently, you know, we're making eye contact, and I'm falling in love right here, and just gonna picture what it would be like to be with this girl, and I mean, this is what sets up the whole video. And we had a great time down here. Probably sung this song 100 times during this whole scene. I started to hate this song after a while, but it's just part of it. It was a lot of fun, and it sets up what this whole song is about. And this next spot right here is actually in the same building. It's just in another room, and it's not every day you have a pretty girl just dancing all up on you and messing with you and taking your hat. She kept taking my hat, and I'm a hat guy. I'm like, quit stealing my hat. But it was funny. We had a good time, and you know, she's a professional, and she made me feel super comfortable. And she's a great, great girl, Christine. She's awesome, and we had a great time. So yeah, now we're outside in downtown LA, and this was really cool because, you know, there was just pedestrians and cars coming around with this big production crew, and, you know, I never experienced that. And it was funny. I'm not an actor by any means, and it was so fun to, you know, just kind of see people's reaction to the whole process of making a movie. This actually right here, the girl running away, she was one of the wardrobe designers and did help with makeup, and she, so it's not actually Christiane running away. I thought that was pretty cool. Just gives it the image that she's just running around messing with me and tearing everything up. Again, flashing back to that same scene and taking my hat again, just like the whole time. It was funny. And yeah, there's my terrible linebacker run. It's pretty embarrassing. I don't know how to run mid-speed all the time. But yeah, that was a lot of fun. It's funny. This is actually my favorite spot of the whole filming process. It was at a place called Angel's Flight, and it's these two tram cars that, you know, go to the top of the hill and come back, and they kind of cross in the middle. And apparently it had been closed down for a good while, and we were the first ones to get to ride it. We got special permission. The film crew, you know, worked that out and pulled some strings, and you kind of see here on by my hip, you can see a rope kind of holding me into it. We rode this thing up and down about 1,000 times. It's like 4 a.m. in the morning, and we're just exhausted, tired, and oh man, but everyone had good, you know, kept good vibes, and we got through it. And then we thought we were done, and they're like, no, now we're getting in the tram, and we're gonna do a whole nother scene. And it was like, oh man. But Christiane, she kept us all up, kept us going, and she was just, you know, she helped me out a lot. I'm not an actor, like I said. You can see me just kind of smirking. I'm laughing. I'm just taking it all in and having a blast. And you know, Victor and Michael, they did such a great job of keeping me comfortable and keeping everyone online and track and for the vision they had in this film and this video. I mean, they did a great job, and they caught the song, what I wanted to say out of it. You know, she's just tearing you to pieces, and that's just what she's doing. She's just messing with you. And even to this last scene where we come back to the first location and finish off the tunnel vision, she just walks right past me, and story of my life.